Hi guys, my name's Ben Taylor and welcome to today's video. Today we're going to be discussing the 5 new RF lenses that Canon are rolling out. Let's roll that intro. If you are new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button and then go along to the notification bell. This is going to update you every time we've got new news, new reviews, and new tutorials for you guys to watch. Okay, let's jump in. About 5 months ago, Canon released the EOS R. This was a full-frame mirrorless camera, and this was designed to kind of compete with the Z7 and the Sony range. Now, they also released an EFM range of lenses. This was dedicated to the mirrorless range of Canon cameras, which at the moment is not that many. But then a few days ago, there was some shock news which was leaked from Canon. This was that there's a new full-frame mirrorless camera from Canon hitting the market. And this is the Canon EOS RP. Now, I've actually made a video all about that camera, so if you'd like to check out all the news on that, then just click the link showing above my head right now. So Canon have now leaked the news that they're releasing 5 new RF lenses which will work in conjunction with the mirrorless cameras. So like it or loathe it, it seems that Canon are doubling down on the mirrorless decisions that they've made so far. Okay, so let's jump in now and have a look at what we know about Canon's new lenses coming so far. First lens that we know that Canon are going to be releasing is a wide angle lens, and this is the 15 through to 35 millimeter. This is going to be an f2.8 lens, and it's going to have USM focus, and it's going to have IS, which is brilliant if you already own a Canon EOS R. And the reason being that Canon didn't put stabilization in the camera body. So this means that now you'll have it in the lens. Also, to add to this lens, it's going to be AL glass, which means it's going to be really good quality. The next lens on the list is a 24 through to 70 millimeter. This is also going to be f2.8, and this is going to have IS. Now, this is surprising because Canon have not put IS on any of their f2.8 lenses in this focal range. They do offer this on the f4, but not on the f2.8. So straight away you can see Canon are covering the focal length range with just two lenses so far, the 15 through to the 35 and the 24 through to the 70. Now Canon's other 24 through to 70 millimeter lens is known for its fantastic image quality. So if this lens is anything to go by that, it will match it or it's going to be even better. And that's because this 24 through to 70 millimeter lens is also AL glass. The third lens on the list is the Canon 70 through to 200 millimeter. This is an f2.8 and this also comes with USM focus and IS, image stabilization. So take a look at the three lenses so far, 15 through to 35, 24 through to 70, and 70 through to 200. Basically, this means that Canon have covered in three lenses the kind of focal length that most photographers will be looking for in their photography. Of course, there's some exceptions to this, but most photographers will be happy with this in three lenses. Canon have also added two more lenses to the lineup. The next lens is an 85mm f1.2. This also has a USM focus. Now, the EF version of this lens is incredible. Any portrait photographers that use this lens will tell you of the image quality. So the fact that Canon are rolling this out into the RF range means that they're gonna have another incredible quality lens which is gonna work alongside the mirrorless cameras. Finally on the list is the Canon 24 through to 240 millimeter, which is quite a large focal length. Now this is not gonna be AL glass, so it's going to sacrifice some quality, but of course this means that it's going to be cheaper. So people are gonna have less money to pay, but the quality may not just be there. It's also gonna have a variable aperture from f4 through to I think f6.3. So this is gonna be aimed at people with a lower budget. So question of the day is, what do you guys think of the new range of RF lenses that Canon will be releasing? Leave your thoughts in the comments section below. Let me know if you think you're going to be good or if you think they're going to be another flop from Canon. And we can talk about this after the video and share our thoughts. I want to let you guys know how appreciative I am that you're watching these videos and joining in and supporting the channel. It means so much to me when I'm making these videos every single week that you enjoy them. So if that is the case, please hit subscribe and then the notification bell. And this just means that you get notified each time I release new news, new reviews, and new tutorials. Whatever you do today, guys, I hope you have an amazing day, and I'll see you all in the next video.